Dear students, welcome to another episode of multi-subject MCQs. First of all, let me know whether you are able to hear me properly in the comment section. I am Dr. Karthikeyan Pethuswamy. I have done my MBBS from Kanyakumari Government Medical College.
Dr. Karthikeyan Pethuswamy.
MD Biochemistry from Maulana Azad Medical College, New Delhi, Senior Residency and PhD from AIIMS New Delhi. I am the author of this book, Biochemistry for Undergraduates, and I am fortunate to have my name acknowledged in Harper 31st edition for my suggestions and corrections. Right. So let's begin with this question. What is the cutoff age for defining precocious puberty in boys? Okay, the question asks about precocious puberty in boys. Answer me. So what is the answer? What is the cutoff age? Is it 9, 10, 11, 12? What is the cutoff age? I am not able to see your answers, so we just refresh this. So I hope after refreshing I will be able to see. Yes, now I can see your answers. So it's good that I refreshed. Okay, Neha Pai's answer. Shivani Singh is saying it is C. What about others? Please answer. Right. The answer is 9. Okay. In females, the cutoff age is 8. In males, the cutoff age is 9. Okay. So, Neha, Shivangi, correct your answers. The answer is 9. Okay. Right. So, isosthenuria is defined as excretion of urine with fixed specific gravity of which of the following? Again, this is a number based question. So what is the cutoff value for isosthenuria? So Neha is saying it is 1.010. What about you, Shivangi? What do you think? What is the answer? Neha is correct. The answer is 10:10. So you can easily remember this as 10:10. Right? Excellent, Neha. Good. Shivangi, the answer is 10:10. Okay, remember. So what is the meaning of iso? Iso means same. So what is isosthenuria then? Isosthenia means the specific gravity of urine is fixed, that is same. Okay, so what is the meaning of this? So when do you have this isosthenuria? The concentration capacity of the kidney is gone. So that is when this condition will happen, right? So 10:10, as Neha is pointing out, this is a dilute urine, right? So there is no concentration. Okay, see, plasma, it should form an ultrafiltrate, then it should be concentrated, right? So here it's not concentration, it is like the glomerular filtrate. Okay, so it is like the 10:10 is the specific gravity of glomerular filtrate, right? Good. Next question. Distended sebaceous glands, which appears as white dots on nose and face of newborn, are known as which of the following? So how will you call these things? Right. Okay. So now Shivangi is saying D and Neha is saying C. Shivangi, excellent, you are correct. Okay, Neha also corrected the answer. Good, Neha. So the answer is milia. So look at this. What you are seeing, can you see? This is like distended sebaceous glands, which appears as white dot, right? So this is neonatal milia. So let me show you the other options also. So this is Mongolian spot. Okay, so don't worry Neha, I'm going to show you all the pictures, okay, so that you will remember this. So this is Mongolian spot. So what is Mongolian spot? This is nothing but congenital dermal melanocytosis. Okay, so what is the cause of this? So this is caused by the entrapment of melanocytes in the lower half to two-thirds of the dermis. So if you see, in the dermis, lower half to two-third, okay, lower half to two-third. So here your melanocytes are trapped, okay, so they are trapped during their embryonic development. So that is why you have this. Excellent, Neha. So it's a migration delay. So this will be non-blanching, very very important. Okay, so you cannot see the answers fully, right? Now wait. Shivangi, okay, wait a bit. Right, now you will be able to see it. So the Mongolian spot will be non-blanching, okay, so it will be hyperpigmented. So let me show you the previous slide also, in case if you want to see the previous slide, you can see the previous slide also. So the Mongolian spot will be non-blanching, hyperpigmented, usually seen over the gluteal region, that presents at the birth or in the first few weeks of life. This will be most prominent at the age of 1 year and it will start regressing after that. Okay, so this is your stark bite. So stark bite, as Neha was saying, it's red, right? So you can see that this is reddish, right? This is due to dilatation of blood vessels due to the influence of maternal hormones. So why is this name stark bite? Why is this fancy name stark bite? Can anyone say what is this has to do with stark and bite? Okay, so this has something to do with the cultural difference. Okay, see, that's what. If you ask someone from Western country, that person will be able to answer very easily, because in Western countries, you know, they believe, right? They don't believe, that they tell the children, okay, they, so if the children ask mother or father from where the kids come, then they say that starts they bring the kids and they deliver. So there is even one Hollywood movie, right? You must be knowing, based on this theme, stork and kids and all, right? So here the story is like that. Okay, so storks are bringing the kids, so at that time there is a bite. Okay, so this is this particular region, right? So this particular region only storks will hold the child and bring, right? So that is why stark white. Understanding? So mainly it's in the back side of the neck, right? Okay. Next question. Which of the following is the condition in which placenta is directly attached to the myometrium? Obstetrics question. Attachment of placenta directly to the myometrium is known as which of the following? Neha, can you revise your answer? Right. Excellent, Shivangi. Excellent. Raj Ravi, good to see you. So, the answer is D. Placenta accreta. So, what is placenta previa? So, here the placental attachment is from a site which is different from the usual site. See, especially it's going to be near the cervix. See, within 2 cm of cervix, placenta covering part of cervix, placenta completely obstructing the cervix. Okay, so that this is your placenta previa. Placenta previa is one of the reasons for bleeding, right? So it causes bleeding. Right. Next. So this diagram shows you the various types of placental insertion. So what you are seeing? Velamentous insertion, circummarginate, circumvallate, bilobed, and this is your battledore or marginal insertion, and this is your succinturate lobe. Okay. Next is on community medicine. Tell me human and anatomical waste, microbiological waste, where will you put this? So where will you dispose this safely? That is the thing, you have to safely dispose. Where will you put all these wastes? Raj Ravi is saying C, Neha is saying C, Lekana Kanikella is also saying C. Good. Excellent. So this is yellow bag. So as most of you are aware, this is the answer. Good, good, good. Nice. So guys, let me tell you, I am going to take another special class. So last time I was taking this ultra rapid revision, and many of the students, they messaged me that they want one more class. So based on popular demand, I'll be taking another class on the day of Holi. Okay, so that is March 29. So I have scheduled for 12 noon. So it will be 12 noon. So most of you will be free only, right? Holi 12 noon. So I know that in holidays you will be sleeping, so that's why I didn't put early also. So it's 12 noon, guys. Attend the class. So this will be more like a clinical case scenarios and all I will discuss. Okay, so don't miss the session. Right, so next we are going to discuss psychiatry. An adult throwing a temper tantrum when he does not get his own way is an example of which of the following? You know, temper tantrums, they are common in children. Okay, so that is their like normal part of development. Nothing abnormal in temper tantrum in children. If you see adult who is throwing a temper tantrum, what does that indicate? What kind of defense mechanism is this? So Raj Ravi is saying it is regression. What about others? What are you guys thinking? Tell me. So, Raj Ravi is correct. Excellent, Raj Ravi. It is regression only. Okay, so one more question. A person is getting some a thought which is unacceptable in the society. Okay, so he is getting some unacceptable thought. Instead of acting on that unacceptable thought, he is going and doing some other activity. Okay, so what is that? So what kind of defense mechanism is this? So he is getting some unacceptable thought or something which he don't want to do, something like he feels like he has to smoke or he feels like something else. So instead of that, he goes and go for a walk, he goes and do exercise. So what kind of defense mechanism is this? Tell me. So out of the options, which one is that? Neha Patil. Okay, Raj Ravi is thinking it is repression. The more correct is that is your sublimation. Clear? So that is your sublimation. Okay. Right. So look at the regressive behavior in hospitalized adult patients. So what are the regressive behavior? So some examples like, see, engaging in quiet baby talk, being incontinent, crying, whining, suddenly becoming mute, playing possum or dumb, right? Physically aggressive, assuming the fetal position. So this all in the hospitalized patient we are saying, okay? So these are all some examples for regressive behavior. Right. So this is kind of emergency medicine question. A patient is suspected with spinal injury in the casualty. So how should the patient be transferred from the examination table to the ward? Raj Ravi, Lekana, what about others? Others can also answer. Okay, Shivangi, good. What is the answer? Excellent. Log, roll, turn. So what is log, roll, turn? See, this is log rolling. Excellent, Knight Rider. So it's like a log, right? So it's like rolling the log. So you have to roll the patient as one unit. Okay. So you should not like moving upper limb separately, lower limb separately, something like that. Okay. So normally if you tell people to move, so someone will hold the upper limb, someone will hold the lower limb, and then there may not be coordination, right? So here we should not move the spine. Okay, the spinal movement should be zero. So that is why at the same time, so at the same time all the people should move the person in one piece. Okay, as in one unit. So this is called log rolling. So these are kind of some applied questions which can come in your exam. All right. So let's discuss some image based questions also. So these are all some physiology questions which have been already asked in the exam. This image shows the lung compliance curve. So A, B and C are marked. Identify what is this A. Identify A. So Sanket Mistry. So Sanket Mistry is thinking A for A. So Raj Ravi is also thinking it is A. Good. Excellent, Shivangi. Nice. So answer is absolutely A only. Emphysema. So look at this. So in emphysema and surfactant therapy. So surfactants, what will they do? They will reduce the surface tension. Okay. They prevent the collapse of the lung, you know, right? Surfactants, they are going to prevent the collapse of the lung alveoli. Okay, so collapse of the lung means it will be downward. See, atelectasis, collapse of lung, right? So ARDS, congestive heart failure, lung congestion. So they are all going to cause this downward shift. Okay, surfactants, they are going to prevent the collapse of the alveoli. So that is why they are going to cause upward shift. Emphysema, you can understand. What is emphysema? Emphysema, there is permanent dilatation of alveoli, right? So hyperinflation. Okay. So there is increased compliance in emphysema. Okay. Good. Another image-based question. Try to identify the area of spinal histology which is involved in the relief of pain in response to massage. Identify. So in the spinal nuclei, so what you are seeing, the spinal nuclei. So Raj Ravi, can you name the area also? What is the name of the area? So touch, pressure and all, they can relieve the pain, right? So you must have heard the name, gate control theory of pain. So use this get control theory of pain, then answer. What could be the answer? Raj Ravi is saying this. Cha, Neha Patil is saying this. So which one? The answer is here also, it is A. See, look at this image. Look at this. So this is your substantia gelatinosa. Have you heard of this? Have you heard? Substantia gelatinosa. So substantia gelatinosa is responsible for relief of pain in massage. Clear? So look at the area. So this is your substantia gelatinosa, nucleus properius, dorsal nuclei, intermediate lateral nucleus, then your motor neurons of anterior horn. Okay. Let's shift to pharmacology or psychiatry. All of the following are side effects of tricyclic antidepressants except, which is not a side effect of TCA. Tell me. So Raj Ravi is saying it is answer D. Sanket Mistry, good. Others, answer fast. Nitya, good. Everyone, feel free to answer. Just don't be silent spectators. Give your answers. Okay. Excellent, excellent, Ragini, Ranjan. Leave your footprint in the comment section. Okay. Right. So, answer is absolutely, as all of you told, it is increased salivation. Why? See, tricyclic antidepressants, they will have what? Excellent, Rajravi, excellent. So, what is will be the side effect? Anticholinergic, right? So, anticholinergic side effects will be there. So, blood vision, urinary retention, raised IOP. So, that is why they are contraindicated in glaucoma. So, you cannot give TCA in glaucoma. So, instead of salivation, you will have dry mouth. Okay. So, what about the side effects of SSRIs? Tell me. SSRI, especially in males. So, SSRIs, they cause some characteristic side effect in males. So, what is that side effects? So, that is your excellent erectile dysfunction and delayed ejaculation. Okay, so these are the characteristic side effect. Excellent, excellent, guys. Good, 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 nice. So let's discuss anesthesia question also. Moribund patient not expected to survive 24 hours without an operation comes under which of the following ASA category? So whenever you plan, tell me, Raj Ravi, do you think it is really answer A? Okay, see now recognizing option D. Mystery is saying 4. Mystery 4 means you are meaning 1, 2, 3, 4 or option C you mean. Okay, Zaheer Papar is also mentioning it is C. Right, let me tell you the answer. It is 5. Look at this. Let me show you the categories. ASA 1 is a normal healthy patient, okay? So like elective procedures and all. So most of the healthy patients, they will come under ASA1. Patients with mild systemic disease, right? So they come under ASA2. Severe systemic disease, ASA3. Severe systemic disease, which is a constant threat to life, ASA4. Look at this. Moribund patient not expected to survive 24 hours without operation come under ASA5, and there is one, I think one more category, that is E, that is your emergency procedure. Okay, clear guys? So I hope now you know ASA category and their explanation, right? So guys, in YouTube we take class, also in an academy we take lots and lots of free special classes. I hope you are all aware of the special classes. So coming 29th, on the day of Holi at 12 noon, I'll be taking 1 hour ultra rapid revision special class. So I want all of you to attend the class. So download the Unacademy app and select your category as NEET PG. Okay, so if you want, you can go for plus subscription also. Otherwise, if you want to unlock the free plan, you just use this code to unlock the free plan. Okay, this code will help you to unlock the free plan also. Clear? So to watch the free special classes of any educator, you can use this code. Okay? So guys, I hope you have enjoyed this session. I hope this session is of some help in clearing some concepts. I'll meet you in one another session. Thanks for joining. Good night. Bye.